Hello everybody, my presentation today will be about choosing to eat healthy or having a better food selection. We have been having a lot of debates on whether it's what we eat or what we do or what is in our food that has contributed to a lot of problems, like nutritionally related problems. And so many people are trying now to shift from organic to non-organic foods. Little do we not even consider some issues that maybe have gathered to, or maybe the ones that have shifted us or taken us to where we are in nutrition and health. And I will be focusing on how to make children know or develop a good eating habits, or they should know how to select good food or nutritionally healthy foods. And the first thing are the parents. The parents should be the role model for their children. They should be the ones who will lead in selecting healthy food, eating healthy food, so that their children will adopt them. Then, in what are the ways that, or how should parents do this? It's very simple. First, when parents are going to groceries to go buy some food, they should take their children to the stores. And from the prior knowledge that they have been teaching their children, they should have taught them on how to make good food selections. Like, they should let their children know that the very important component of healthy foods are fruits. And when children go to store, they buy fruits like an apple, they can buy bananas, and they can buy healthy things instead of buying junky food, like maybe I need a cookie or frozen foods like chips or any food that is junky. So that way children will have that habit of knowing what to select based on what they have seen their parents do, and they have had a chance to exercise it. And the other way, other than selecting the foods from the grocery store, is how to cook the food. That is a very important factor. People buy very healthy food, but the way they go and cook it, it makes it very unhealthy. I am going to use an example here of cornmeal. This is the most stable food that I always eat. I cook it plainly. I just add water and use the cornmeal to stir it until it's like a tough dough. And I have tried this with a lot of friends, and once they taste it, they're like, Marko, this doesn't taste like anything. We need butter, we need something on it. Little do they know that they are adding some unnecessary things that they don't even require to be here. We know whatever is here, when you cook it the way it is, all the components, all the fat that they say, 0 grams fat, 111 or 10 calories, 2 grams of proteins, 1 gram of fiber, 24 grams of carbohydrate, they are in there without necessarily adding a lot of things. People use corn meal to make bread, and they use varieties of cooking oils. This is a good cooking oil. It's a vegetable oil. It has omega-3, zero trans fat, cholesterol free, and it has like 14 grams fat. And but people would end up using like saturated oils or fat to cook cornmeal. By the end, the cornmeal is ready to be consumed as food. It's already junk. Not that it's because it's organic or non-organic, it's because of how it has been prepared. And the other important factor, and this is something that it has to be promoted, is exercise. As long, even if you eat a very healthy food like organic food without exercise, I guarantee you, it's not gonna be the same again. You will develop, like, you will gain a lot of weight, you will be an obese, you will be at a high risk of cardiovascular diseases, even if you are eating very healthy. So, as much as we are trying to eat either organic or whatever people think it is healthy, we also need to know that the energy we put in, we need to exercise or get it out of our bodies. We need to burn the calories. We don't just need to stuff a lot of energy or kilocalories in our bodies and we don't exercise. The other thing that we combine with good eating habits is how we spend our free time. Most of the time, children spend almost the entire time on video games or on Facebook, and they don't have time to think and exercise and play around and have time for the body to take the necessary nutrients. Somebody eats, and instead of now after they eat, they relax a little bit and go out and exercise. They just sit down and watch TV, and then finally they lay down and they have burned zero calories. This doesn't have to do, or it doesn't have any relation with whether the food is organic or is or non-organic. The thing is, you ate a lot of food and you didn't exercise. So if we develop those few things that I have said, among many, many, many other things, I know it's a broad topic. We can even take a whole semester, I think, to teach people on how to select healthy food. I was shocked that the other time I did my first nutrition class, and I was told, you know, there was a question that was asking, what do Americans base their food selection on? And I thought it would be on nutritional content, but the best answer was taste. So it does. People would like to eat something that tastes better to them, without even considering is it nutritionally healthy or is it a junky food. So what we need to do is we change our habits. Good food selection, better methods of cooking and exercising very well. If we do all those things, we will have a very healthy life. Thank you very much.